Hello and welcome back to channel CodeX. This is your host Afzal, and today we are going to start a new Flutter development series. We will be creating this beautiful application by the end of the series, and I will upload each week one part of the video. Make sure that you subscribe the channel so that you don't miss any of the update. Well, that's being said, let's start our development with part one of the video, where we are going to create this animated clock right inside Flutter. Let's jump into tutorial. So we are into Visual Studio Code now. You can see this is a default template of Flutter application. Here I have created one page called home page, and you can see that it's a blank page with a scaffold structure. We are going to start the design process with a container, and I will apply a background color to this container. This color we are going to fetch from Adobe XD. So what I have done, I have already fetched all the colors used in this design in Adobe XD. You can do that simply by drawing a shape and using an eyedropper, you can pick the color. So I'm going to copy this color from here and paste it inside Visual Studio. Just remove the hash key, and you can see that we get the container with the background. Perfect. Next, we want to define clock view. So for that, I will create a separate file called clockview.dart. And in this file, I'm going to create a stateful widget. Let me first import material.dart, and now we will create a stateful widget. I will tell you at the end of the video why we need a stateful widget. To start with container, we will give it a width and height. So I'll say 300 width and 300 of height. And we will use custom paint as child of this container. So this widget is going to be the key widget for this tutorial. We're going to create a custom painter, and I will name it as clock painter. So let's go ahead and create our custom class, and this class will extend from custom painter. Now inside this class, we'll have to implement all the virtual methods or abstract methods. So there are two methods. One is the paint method, and second one is should repaint. So we'll say just return true from should repaint, that it should repaint whenever there's a state change, and rest of the thing we are going to do in this paint method. The first parameter is a canvas where we're gonna draw everything, and the second parameter is size, which defines the size of the canvas. So let's go ahead and use this clock view inside our page. Now you can see that our container shrinks to this top left corner because our canvas has a size of 300 by 300. What we're going to do, we're going to provide the center alignment to this container so that it again fills the entire space. So now we can start painting on the canvas. Before that, what I will do, I will open the image, the final output which I want to achieve, and I will place this image in the bottom left corner, so that while developing, I can see and refer this image anytime. That's a handy way while you are designing. So you can do this trick. You can put your image somewhere in the screen so that you see it while designing. And now you're gonna see a lot of mathematic calculation, a lot of paint brushes. So don't get afraid, I'll make it simple for you. Let's begin the show. So first thing I want to calculate is the center point. Center in X direction and center in Y direction. So it will be size dot width by 2 and size dot height by 2. Now let's create a variable which will hold this offset. So we'll say offset center X comma center Y. So now this center knows the exact point. Now we gotta start painting on the canvas. So the first thing we will paint is the circle. You can see that it requires three parameters. So first parameter we have, that is the center point. We don't have radius and we don't have paintbrush. So let's calculate radius now. The radius should be such that it fits inside the canvas. So it may happen that your canvas has a different width and different height. So using size.width/2 will not work because it may happen that it exceeds in the height. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna use math.min method, and we'll pass center X and center Y, which is size.width/2 and size.height/2. So it will give you the minimum of radius. So the second parameter got resolved. Now we have to define a paintbrush. Now major chunk of our source code will be paintbrushes. So don't worry about the length of the source code. It's all simple paint methods. You can achieve whatever you want to draw with these paintbrushes. So you can define color, you can define stroke, width, gap, and all those properties. So I'm gonna pick the color from Adobe XD again. If you want to know more about Adobe XD, then I have multiple tutorials. I'll put link in the description. You can go ahead and check how to use Adobe XD. Fine, now let's use this fill brush inside the parameter, and we got the circle drawn. Now what I'm going to do next is reduce the radius of this circle, because we want some space to draw these dashes. So we will reduce it by 40 pixel, and you got the smaller circle like this. And now next, we're gonna design the outline. So for outline also, we want at the same radius, same center point, but we want a different paintbrush. So for that, I will say outline brush, and this outline, we are going to change the color. So this is going to be this off-white color. And also along with the color, we have to specify different properties like stroke width and stroke type. So let me define that. We'll say stroke width of 16 pixel. And also we have to change the style. So by default, it takes fill style. So we're gonna change the style to paint style of stroke. I hope it's pretty clear. Now we're gonna copy paste the same, but this time we want a radius of fixed size, that's 16 pixel radius, and we will create a new brush for center dot. Perfect, now you know how to create a brush. What I'm gonna do next is create second, minute, and hour and brush quickly. Just like that, and I'll copy paste all of this code. Now for the minute hand brush, we want a gradient, and that we can achieve with the help of a shader inside paint. This shader can be either linear gradient or radial gradient depending on the need. And inside that, you can define the multiple colors which you want in the gradient. And then again, we'll have to create shader from that gradient, and that requires a rectangle. We have multiple options to create a rectangle, but I'm gonna create a rectangle from circle because we already have the center point and the radius. And the same thing we will apply for our hand, and let's start painting this on canvas. So we want to draw the line on canvas that requires three parameters. First is the starting point, second is the ending point, and third one is the paint itself. Now the first point we know, that is center. The second point we are going to hard code for now. We will say 100 by 100 pixel, and the paint we already have it. We'll use sec hand brush. The first thing we notice is that the line has a rectangular cap, and we want a rounded cap. The way we can achieve it, we have to customize the brush so that it gives a rounded cap. Secondly, we can see that the line has been drawn on top of the center dot. So what we can do, we can move this center dot below the second minute and hour hand so that it draws on top of that. So in your code, it has to be below everything so that it draws on top of that. This is how it works. The last you draw is going to be on top. Now we are going to duplicate this line to create minute and hour hand, and we'll put some random hard-coded values to see it in effect. Later we will modify it. And also we will change the gradient color of minute and hour from Adobe XD. Perfect, that looks awesome. Now we are going to calculate the actual values which will draw this second minute and hour hand. So we want to calculate the second coordinate. Now to do that, we will need to apply this mathematics formula that we have the radius and we want to find a point on the circumference of that circle. To find out the x coordinate, we will multiply the radius with cos angle, and to find out the y coordinate, we will multiply the radius with sine angle. Because these values are in degrees, so we have to convert it to radian, and for that we can multiply by pi by 180, and this pi comes from math.dart. So this is all just simple mathematics, and you can master this with practice. So now we got both x and y coordinate. So we are going to place these values inside the second coordinate of this line, and that we can see that this line disappears. The reason I did a mistake calculating x and y coordinate, that I only provided the center x and not the actual radius. So from center point, at what distance you want the coordinate, that you have to provide. So say for example, I will say 80 pixels away. Now when we hot reload the application, we will get a line which is originating from the center and goes till 80 pixel. So I'm gonna reorder these lines in a manner that second comes on the top, and below that there's a minute hand, and below that there's an hour hand. We are going to copy the same logic for minute and hour coordinates calculation. So it's pretty simple. Let me do a fast forward for you guys. Cool, now the design looks awesome to me. So now instead of putting a hard-coded value for these degrees, we will calculate the actual value. I know this video is getting lengthier, but guys, this is something related to mathematics, calculation that I cannot avoid. We have to go through it. Fine, what I have done here is created a date time object, which gives me the current date time. Now with this date time, we are going to calculate each degree. We know that it takes 60 seconds to complete 360 degree rotation for a second hand. So that makes that for 1 second, it will take 6 degree, 360 divided by 60, right? So let's go to paint method and modify the values. Instead of this hard coded 90 degree, I'm going to say date time dot second, that how many second it has passed, and that we will multiply with 6 degree. For each second we are multiplying with 6 degree. So if it's 30 second, it will become 180 degree, like that. And same thing we will apply for y coordinate. And when you reload the application multiple times, you will see that the second hand is moving. Perfect, this is what we wanted. We will apply the same logic on minute hand, because for minute hand also, it takes 60 minutes to complete 360 degree rotation. So again, it will, for each minute, we will multiply by 6 degrees in x and y coordinates. And we can see that the minute hand got updated. So each time you refresh, you will see like each minute, it will have a different pointer. For our hand also, we can apply the same logic, but there's extra calculation for it, because we don't want to update the hour hand after 1 hour. Each minute we want to increase it gradually, so that we'll multiply each hour with 30 degree, and each minute we'll multiply by 0.5 degree. You can see the calculation that I have done earlier. I'm not going to explain that, that will take a lot of time. So basically what I'm doing is, for each minute I'm adding 0.5 degree extra, and that moves the hour each minute to its position. If you want to try this source code for yourself, I have shared it on Git source. You can copy the gist ID and paste it on dartpad.dev. If you want to know more about DartPad, check out my previous tutorial where I have explained in detail the features of DartPad and how to use a gist inside DartPad. Now, an important thing to notice about the canvas, that it starts its calculation from this point, which is a 90 degree for us. So we have to rotate the entire canvas 90 degree anti-clockwise. For that, I'm going to use transform.rotate method, and that needs an angle to rotate the children. We will say here, we want to rotate the children by 90 degree, which is pi by 2. And we want it in anti-clockwise direction, so that we will specify minus pi by 2. And now it's showing the correct time, which is 10 to 10. Now I just updated the stroke width for all the hands. And now we will write a logic to animate the clock itself. And that is the reason we are using stateful widget, so that we can set the state and update the UI. To override init state method, and inside that I will implement a periodic timer. This periodic timer will run after each second, and after each second what it will do is it will just set the state, and with set state it's gonna update the entire UI automatically. One final thing we are going to do is we are going to draw these outer dashes. It's pretty simple logic that we are calculating the x and y for outer circle, and we are creating x and y for inner circle, and we are drawing lines after each 12 degree. It's that simple. And with that, we came to end of our video. In next video, we're going to create the first page of this clock application. So make sure you subscribe the channel, hit the like button, and give your feedback. See you guys in the next one. So make sure that you subscribe the channel if you don't want to miss any of the update.